time to play the game. It's all about the game, and how you play it, all about control, and if you can take it, all about.
Welcome to the special Arnold Fitness Weekend edition of Muscle in the Morning, brought to you by Iron Mag Labs, the most hardcore bodybuilding supplements on the market. I'm your host, Dave Palumbo, and I'm here to bring you all the latest news in the world of bodybuilding and fitness. It's Friday, March 6, 2015, and let's get to it. There might not be another athlete receiving less attention heading into the 212 showdown at the Arnold Classic than the UK's Sean Tavernier. The former British national champion was a top 10 finisher on the Olympia stage and Flex Magazine Rookie of the Year once upon a time, but abruptly dropped off the radar for several years before reappearing suddenly last year. When he was at his best, Tavernier showed that he was capable of hanging with the best in the sport, and today will be the test of tests for the genetically talented Brit as he faces off against the likes of Jose Raymond, Eduardo Correa, Hide Yamagishi, and Aaron Clark. Over the years, hundreds and thousands of athletes have gravitated to the bodybuilding world in an effort to look like a real-life superhero. And there aren't many athletes in the sport today who look more cartoonish than Ruly Winkler, appropriately nicknamed the Beast. Although he's been relatively quiet throughout his prep, judging from his most recent photos, Winkler looks poised to make some serious noise. But as we've seen before, Ruly's freak appeal makes him look like Mr. Olympia in the gym alone. But the true test will be if his look and conditioning hold up under the stage's bright lights and he squares off against Cedric McMillan, Justin Compton, and Dexter Jackson tomorrow afternoon. Fouad Abiad is looking as big as a house 6 weeks out from his 2015 debut. After tipping the scales at over 290 pounds in the offseason, Abiad looks to be on the fast track to hitting the stage at his all-time best. Back in 2008, Abiad made his only uneventful appearance on the Olympia stage, but if he's able to snag a qualification at the FIBO Power in Germany, his next trip to Las Vegas will certainly be one to remember. After seeing his contest placings improve in each of his four contests since turning pro, it doesn't look like Ken Jackson has any plans of reversing the trend. Jackson was seen absolutely crushing back earlier in the week as he gears up to make another strong push in 2015. Last season, Jackson brought his best look ever to the IFBB Tampa Pro, which earned him a 9th place finish for his efforts. But after another very solid offseason and some thick slabs of new muscle, Jackson looks poised to make 2015 the best year of his career. With under 10 weeks to go until he makes his 2015 debut at the New York Pro 212, it doesn't look like Guy Cisternino is playing any games. Last season, Cisternino had the best year of his young career, notching wins in Toronto and Dallas, and arguably being overlooked on the Olympia stage in the European Tour. And after getting a solid taste of victory last season, Cisternino appears to be as hungry as ever to sink his teeth back into the competition and take a major bite out of 2015. And that does it for yet another edition of Muscle in the Morning, brought to you by Iron Mag Labs, the most hardcore bodybuilding supplements on the market. Check out IronMagLabs.com today. I'm your host, Dave Palumbo, reminding you to always be true to your passions. And make sure to follow us on Twitter, Facebook, and Instagram.